Hey guys, I'm going to show you how you could test if you have a genuine spark plug by checking the resistance. There are a ton of fake copies in the market and this is a global problem. On this multimeter, I have set it to 20,000 ohms. And here I have a genuine NGK spark plug. Here you can see the part number. The R that you see, this means that this is a resistor type of plug. I asked NGK about this, where they say the acceptable range for these type of plugs are 3,500 to 7,500 ohms. And you can see on the plug itself, there's an R written on it. On the NGK website, you can see the resistor value for this spark plug is at 5,000 ohms. So let's test this. I'm going to put one end of the probe over here and the other one on the electrode. It doesn't work if I put it on the side because I believe there's some coating on it. So I'm going to put it in the center, but be careful. This is a new spark plug, so don't want to damage this. So let's see, we get 4.97. So that's basically 5,000. So that's perfect. Now let me test the other spark plug. Again, perfect. This particular spark plug is used in Honda i-dsi engines. So this was used in the first gen Honda Fit, Jazz, fourth gen Honda City. This uses two spark plugs per cylinder. I'll test all eight of them. You can see the results on your screen. The sixth plug I tested here, you can see 5.44. So that's just under 5,500 ohms. And from what I checked online, a plus minus 10% tolerance is acceptable, so I won't be worried about it. Here I have a spark plug that has been used for 100,000 kilometers. And you can see the part number here. And this is also used on the Honda Fit, Jazz, and City on VTEC engines. So here you can see R. It is a resistor type plug. So let me test the resistance on this. Now this is an iridium tip. This one is a nickel tip. So 3.31. So I'll check the other three plugs and show that on the screen. Okay, all done. I know these plugs are genuine and the results show. All readings are between 3,300 and 3,500 ohms. Now, this particular spark plug, you can see there is a brown staining over here. Now, this doesn't mean that there's some sort of leakage happening from the combustion chamber. But this is basically a corona stain, and NGK does address this on their website. So this is just a light brown staining, and this is perfectly normal. It doesn't mean there's anything wrong with the plug. As the electrode wears, the gap increases, the resistance level of plugs do go higher. Here, those things look fine, but there's fouling. Some years back, we had issues where local refineries were adding MMT and ferrocene additives to fuel. That leaves behind manganese and iron oxide deposits that are conductive. This results in lower resistance. Carbon deposits also are conductive. So I believe that is what happened here. As a final comparison, I have here used plugs, the same model of the new ones I showed earlier. These are only driven 20,000 kilometers. These are nickel plated, rated for around 40,000 kilometers or 30,000 miles. We can see a good amount of carbon fouling. With fake plugs, new or old, resistance levels tend to be all over the place. Here are the resistance levels. So this tells me these plugs are genuine. Visually also, they look genuine. You can see here, it says the model number and Japan. If you are in the US, it may say assembled in USA from Japanese parts. I can clearly see over here the production lot number. And you can confirm this from NGK. The housing body doesn't look uneven, scratched, or warped in any way. The tip looks fine. And the resistance, as I've just shown, is also fine. However, I had to scrape carbon from the electrode tip a fair bit just to get a reading. The ignition coils that were on these plugs, the age was unknown. One, in fact, had some sort of repair. Bad ignition coils can contribute to carbon fouling of spark plugs due to incomplete combustion. So while the resistance is fine on these plugs, the engine these came off from performed poorly. In all fairness, these plugs probably could have been cleaned, but these are the cheapest version plugs. In my opinion, it is just better to replace them. I hope you found this video useful. In future, I will look to buy fake plugs to give a better comparison of resistance values and visual differences. As always, guys, thanks for watching.